Hi everyone, I'm Ricky from TechTalk and today is my personal video I really like to do on all devices that I look at on the channel. So today we're taking a look at the accessibility settings on the Vodafone Smart N9 Lite. So to find this, first of all, is quite easy and simple. So what you need to do is press your menu button here in the middle. You then go to settings, which is the gear icon here, swiping all the way down to the bottom. So go all the way down. We count four from the bottom, 1, 2, 3, 4, you have accessibility. And inside here, you should find a range of settings to help you. So at the top, you've got helpful tips. So underneath that, you can then set a shortcut. So if we go in here, we can toggle on and then we can choose the option that we want. So we're going to use talk back and then okay, and I'll demonstrate that a little while later. So underneath here we have downloaded services. So you've got select to speak, switch access, talk back, which is a great feature. You've got text to speech output, font size. So if we go font size here, we've got it on the largest here, so we can hit done there. Underneath that you have display size, so this can make the icons a little bit bigger as well for you. Again, this is on the largest section here, which is really nice. Then you have magnification. So if we go into magnification here, inside here you have magnify with triple touch. So we're going to toggle this on. So 1, 2, 3. So three quick taps will enlarge your display. You can then pinch to zoom as well. Then with two fingers, you can then move around your display. So 1, 2, 3, and you'll come back. There is also another option. If you go 1, 2, 3, and then hold with just one finger, it just quickly zooms in. You can look around, move around with one finger, and then release to come back, which is great. I'm gonna keep that on. Then you have magnify with buttons. So once toggled on, you'll get this fourth icon down here. So you can tap once, and then pinch in, then again, tap again, then touch and hold the display to really zoom in with one finger, and then you can really scrub around really quickly and look for what you need. That's a great option there. That's also a new option that I haven't come across yet, which is really nice to see. You have color correction, so we can go in here and turn color correction on if you so wish to. This again will make the colors a little bit more easier to understand. Also, once you go home, you'll see a slight difference in the colors on the home screen, so please be aware of this. Then you also have color inversion if it's easier to read like this, but this will really scramble up the colors as well. But if you do put on color correction as well, this will try and solve the issue for you. You have a large mouse cursor, so you can use a cursor for this device if you so wish to. And then you've got click after cursor stops moving. Again, this is with a mouse. You can use your power button to end calls. Auto screen rotate, so if you turn this on, you can just turn your screen around for you and it will flip around and make it ever so easy, which is really nice. And this will do that wherever you are on the device and in apps if it allows it. Touch and hold delay, that's for dexterity. You have mono audio option as well. You have captions down here at the bottom. You have high contrast text. So if I toggle this on, you can see the text becomes a little bit bolder and a little bit easier to see. And you've got schedule power off and on for the device. You can schedule your device to come off and on. The two major features with this device is TalkBack, which is a great feature, and also the magnification, which I went through. So going into TalkBack here, let's toggle TalkBack on.
TalkBack on. TalkBack is a screen reader primarily for people with blindness and low vision. It allows interaction with the device using spoken feedback.
That's really helpful. So we need to highlight.
Back button.
Double tap.
TalkBack.
So what it will do is talk back everything that's on your device for you. So I can highlight here. So as you can see, it's highlighted a box here, and then to make an action come true or actually happen, you need to double tap that. So if we highlight the Vodafone at the top.
Selected, Vodafone UK, Gmail notification, eBay, 1108, battery 98%.
So it will read out everything to you and you'll use the device to make it a lot more simple and a lot more easier. So if we go back to the menu here.
Navigate up button, accessibility, navigate up button.
To go through the menu system, you will need two fingers. And you'll hear a sound going up and down. This will make it easier for people like myself with a vision impairment to use this device. So also there is another feature on here as well that I want to show you. So if we go back into TalkBack. So now TalkBack is off. There's also another option if you don't want to hear it all the time. You can use select to speak. So let's turn this on and we're going to hit OK. So now select to speak is on and toggled as our favorite. If I press it here, I can then read through the whole lot.
Navigate up, select to speak, on, settings. When select to speak is on, you...
So I can pause it and press again and then press in an area.
When select a speaker's on, you can tap specific items on.
So I can tap specific items and get to know what I want to hear instead of hearing through the whole list. And it's great that option is there as well. So when on the home screen, I talked about a shortcut option for accessibility settings, saving going through the menu. So if you press and hold the volume keys together, so hold for 3 seconds.
Talk back on.
So holding for 3 seconds, we'll put talk back on. And again, we can use that straight away. So now it will read everything that's out to me. So I can then highlight applications.
Tips, calendar, so actions, shortcuts, remove app info, move item, double tap to activate, double tap and hold to long press.
So it's giving you options there and commands what you need to do to use. So to turn this off, press and hold them 3 buttons again.
Talk back off.
So that makes it nice and easy and simple for the device to be used. The screen on this device is okay. It's not great from every single angle. So if I turn it like this, it goes very dark. So you do need to look at this full on. Otherwise, the display is okay. It moves through the accessibility settings okay. The talkback feature can be a little bit sluggish sometimes due to the power and performance in this device. But otherwise, it does work and it is there for you to use. If you have any questions or queries, please drop a comment down below and I'll be more than happy to help. Thanks always for watching. From me, Ricky. I'll see you in my next video. Bye for now.